So essentially today I want to run you through the anatomy of a training session, right? Like, what does the training session look like? What are the pieces, what are the parts that make up a great and complete training session? Every training session starts with some level of SMR, right? Self-myofascial release. And this is essentially, we're more just bringing awareness to tissue, number one, and number two, increasing blood flow. And through those things, yeah, maybe we get, you know, a better feeling or a better movement quality after the fact. But we do know that it helps our athletes move and feel better. So we always start with that. It could be lacrosse ball work. It could be foam roller work. It could be peanut work. We have all these different tools, massage guns, all these different things that essentially just, again, bring awareness, bring blood flow to areas and get guys moving and feeling better going into a training session. The next piece of that is gonna be some targeted mobility work. And we're also gonna kind of weave with our targeted mobility work, our activation work, right? And what is targeted mobility? Well, it's essentially targeting tissues that we know in most of our athletes or in our athletic populations that are tight, restricted, bound up, underactive, or overactive, right? And it's targeting those things, getting them to move from a state of being maybe either A, hypertonic, or B, in a position where they're not optimal in terms of a length tension relationship, to moving them into a more optimal position, right? So we do some mobility work. And for us, normally, we're gonna always target the hips, we're gonna always target the thoracic spine because we deal with baseball players, and those are common areas of issues or common faults for most of our baseball guys. Next up, after our mobility, we're gonna get into some power training, right? And what is power? Power is essentially building the engine as it goes onto the field, right? Building the transition or the transfer of training into actual sport. So our power training might include jumps, it might include throws, it might include sprints on certain days, right? And all of this is power, and then, you know, we can kind of asterisk this as well and put our speed training in here as well, right? And that's always gonna come before our strength training work. And the reason for that is because of the nervous system dominance, right? We do not want to do highly nervous system dominant activity or high speed type of movements after we strength train, right? We don't want to come into these movements in a fatigue state. We don't want to come into these movements with performing suboptimally or at a suboptimal output. So again, speed, power comes first. Then finally, we get to our strength portion of the day. Our strength stuff is really kind of multifaceted. Number one, we wanna be fairly specific in the positions that we choose to strengthen and in the muscular regions that we choose to strengthen, right? We wanna target the tissues that we know these athletes are gonna use on the field, right? And we wanna soup up that engine. And the way I talk to guys about this is, you know, more so than anything else, strength training makes us more robust. It makes us more resilient to injury, which are great things. And at certain levels in your training career, strength training will obviously increase your maximal outputs on the field. Now, there is a point of diminishing returns there, and even at those points, we're still gonna include some extensive strength training to make sure our athletes are robust enough to withstand the other power, speed, training, and skill-specific training that they'll go through throughout the course of their season. So that's essentially the anatomy of a training session, guys. Quick review: self-myofascial release, mobility, activation, power, speed, strength, and then that's it. Afterwards, we're always gonna do some level of cool down. We're gonna do some level of maybe more soft tissue work. The way that that normally works is something that we targeted that day. Again, bringing blood flow, bringing awareness to those tissues. For today, we'll cut it there. That is your basic anatomy of a training session. Peace.